Good morning, students. My name is Y. Ravi Kumar, schoolist and mathematics, ZPH Chilukuru, Chilukuru Mandal, Suryapet district. Today we are going to learn about triangles, chapter number 7. In this chapter, we have to study about congruency of triangles. Before that, we have to recall some knowledge which we have studied earlier. Right? Children, when we say two line segments are congruent, if the lengths of the line segments are equal, then we can say that the given two line segments are congruent. When we say two angles are congruent, if the measurement of the angles are equal, then we can say about the given angles are congruent, right? When we say two circles are congruent, the radii of two circles are equal, then we can say that the two circles are congruent. Also, if the sides of the square are equal, if the side of the square is equal to the side of the another square, then we say that the given two squares are congruent. What is meant by congruency? If we superpose the one figure with another figure, for example, if we superpose one circle with another circle, these two are circle. For example, this circle is superposed with this circle, it covers the another circle exactly, right? It covers the another circle exactly. Then we can say these two circles are congruent circles. Congruent means equal in all aspects. Right. When we say two squares are congruent, if one square is superposed with another square, then it covers exactly with the another square, then we can say these two squares are congruent squares. When it is possible the side of the square is equal to the side of the another square, then only it will possible. Otherwise, it will not. Also, if the diagonal of the square is equal to the diagonal of the another square, then also these two squares are congruent. See here, if we superpose this square with this, is it covers exactly? No. So these two squares are not congruent, because the sides of the given squares are not equal. Because of that, these two squares are not congruent. Not congruent. When we take these two rulers as line segments, when these two line segments are equal, for example, when we superpose the one line segment with another line segment, this covers another line segment exactly, then only we say that these two line segments are congruent. That means the lengths of the line segments are equal. If the lengths of the line segments are equal, then we can say these two line segments are congruent. If the lengths are equal, then the lengths of the line segments are if the lengths of the line segments are equal, then given two line segments are congruent. Also, if the measurement of two angles are equal, these two are right angles. See, these two are right angles. So if we cover one right angle with another right angle, see here, these two are perfectly covers one angle with another angle. Therefore, these two angles are congruent angles. So, we can expand this knowledge to triangles. When we say two triangles are congruent, if we superpose one triangle with another triangle, if it covers the another triangle exactly, then we can say that these two triangles are congruent triangles. What is meant by congruency? Congruency means equal in all aspects. That means the sides are equal. Also, the angles, corresponding angles are equal. The corresponding sides of the triangles are equal, and the corresponding angles of the given triangles are equal, then only one triangle covers the another exactly. Otherwise, this is not possible. Right. See here, when we superpose one triangle with another triangle, see here, it covers exactly. So these two triangles are congruent triangles. If we change the given order, this order, for example, I can change this vertex to this one. Here, I can change this vertex to here. Now, the two triangles covers one and each other exactly or not? No. So, in this position, these two triangles are not congruent. When these two triangles are congruent, if this vertex falls on this vertex only, and this with this, and this vertex with this only, these two triangles are congruent triangles. Otherwise, if we change this order, these two triangles are not congruent triangles, because these two are not covers with another. See here, we can take two triangles. For example, this is a triangle, triangle A, B, C. This is a triangle A, B, C. A, B, C. And we take another triangle, triangle P, Q, R. These two triangles, if we cover one triangle, if we superpose one triangle with another triangle, is it covers exactly with another? Yes, these two are covers exactly with another. So, we can say that these two triangles are congruent triangles. When these two triangles are congruent triangles, if vertex A falls on vertex P, in this position, vertex A falls on vertex P. Also, vertex B falls on vertex Q. See here, if we take two triangles, triangle ABC, triangle ABC, and triangle PQR. If we superpose triangle ABC with triangle PQR, what will happen? Triangle ABC covers triangle PQR exactly. Triangle ABC covers triangle PQR exactly. In this position, what will happen? See here. Vertex A falls on vertex P. Vertex A falls on vertex P. In this position, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Why triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR? Because if we superpose triangle ABC with triangle PQR, then the triangle ABC covers triangle PQR exactly. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Now, see here, in this position, what is happening here? Vertex A falls on vertex P, and vertex B falls on vertex Q, and vertex C falls on vertex R. In this position, what will happen? Vertex A falls on What is A falls on? Vertex P and vertex B falls on vertex Q and vertex C falls on vertex R. Also see here in this position side AB is equal to side PQ. See here side AB is equal to side PQ. So side AB is equal to side PQ. And side BC is equal to side QR, side BC is equal to side QR, and side AC is equal to side PR. Also, angle A equal to angle P, angle B is equal to angle Q, and angle C is equal to angle R. So in this position, what will happen? Now, if we superpose triangle ABC with the triangle PQR, side AB is equal to side PQ, side BC is equal to side QR, and side AC is equal to side PR, and angle A equal to angle P, angle B equal to angle Q, and angle C equal to angle R. Therefore, 6 equalities are hold good. What are 6 equalities here? 3 corresponding sides and 3 corresponding angles. Right? So, when two triangles are congruent, then corresponding what? There is one-to-one correspondence between the vertices. That is, A falls on P, B falls on C, Q, and C falls on R. In this position, side AB is equal to side PQ, side BC equal to side QR, side AC is equal to side PR. Also, angle A equal to angle P, angle B equal to angle Q, and angle C equal to angle R. When we change the order, if in this position, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR now, because if we superpose triangle ABC with the triangle PQR, this covers the another triangle exactly. Therefore, we can say triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. If we change the order, for example, here vertex A falls on vertex B. Now I can change this order to vertex form A falls on vertex Q. What will happen here? See. In this position, two triangles are covers exactly with another triangle? No. Therefore, in this position, these two triangles are not congruent. Only if A falls on P and B falls on Q and C falls on R, only these two triangles are congruent. Other than this order, these two triangles are not congruent. For example, if we change this order, here these two are not congruent. Also, if we change this order to here, these two are not congruent, because these two are not covers another exactly. Therefore, if you represent the congruency using the symbols, we must follow the order. That means, if we denote triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, when this means triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR means AB side AB equal to side BQ, side AB equal to side BQ. See here order, side AB equal to side BQ and side BC equal to side QR. Side BC equal to side QR and side AC equal to side PR. So, these three sides are called corresponding sides. Therefore, when two triangles are congruent, then corresponding sides are equal. Corresponding sides are equal. How many sides in a triangle? Three sides. So, in triangle ABC,
the three sides are equal to the corresponding three sides of triangle PQR. Also, angle A is equal to angle Q, angle B is equal to angle A equal to angle B, and angle B equal to angle Q, and angle C equal to angle R. So, if triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, then angle A equal to angle P, angle P equal to angle Q, angle C equal to angle R. If it denotes triangle ABC is congruent to triangle QPR, is it correct? So AB equal to PQR QP is right. AB PQ, okay. But BC, side BC is not equal to side PR, because side BC equal to side QR. Therefore, if triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, we must denote this order only. Otherwise, this order, the congruency not correct. Triangle ABC is now ABC is not congruent to triangle PQR, because angle A is not equal to angle Q. Because angle A equal to angle P, we must denote the order triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. So, see here, if triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, then there is 6 equalities are hold good. What are the 6 equalities here? 3 corresponding sides and 3 corresponding angles. Therefore, if we denote triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, that means 3 corresponding sides are equal to the corresponding 3 sides of another triangle. Also, corresponding angles are equal to the corresponding 3 angles of the another triangle. From the above discussions, we have concluded a statement, that is, two triangles are congruent if and only if there exists a correspondence between their vertices, such that the corresponding sides and the corresponding angles of the two triangles are equal. See here, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR here, right? So, what is happening here? In this position, the corresponding sides and the corresponding angles of two triangles are equal. What are the corresponding sides? See here, if triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR means, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR means, the corresponding sides of these two triangles, that means side AB equal to side PQ, side AB equal to side PQ, and side BC equal to side QR, and side AC equal to side PR. Also, angle A equal to angle P, and angle B equal to angle Q, angle C equal to angle R. Therefore, when triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, here 6 equalities are hold good. That means the corresponding sides are equal and the corresponding angles are equal. So, corresponding 3 sides are equal to the corresponding 3 sides of the other triangle. Also, corresponding angles are equal to the corresponding angles of another triangle. These 6 parts are called corresponding parts of congruent triangles. These 6 equalities are called corresponding parts of congruent triangles. These 6 equalities are called corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Simply we can denote this as CBCD. CBCD means corresponding parts of congruent triangles. What are corresponding parts here? Here the corresponding parts are side AB equal to side PQ and side BC equal to side QR, side AC is equal to side PR. That means the corresponding three sides are equal to the corresponding three sides of the another triangle. Also, corresponding three angles are also equal to the corresponding three angles of the another triangle. Therefore, these six equalities are called corresponding parts of congruent triangle. When it is possible, if triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, when we denote the congruency with using the letters, using the symbols, we must follow the letters in triangle in particular order. That means in this situation, angle A falls on angle P, and angle B falls on angle Q, and angle C falls on angle R. Because of that, we can represent this congruency as triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. So that means angle A is equal to angle P, and angle B is equal to angle Q, and angle C is equal to angle R. We must follow this order, otherwise this it will went wrong. From the above discussion, we have noticed that if two triangles are congruent, then six equalities are holdable. What are the six equalities? Corresponding three sides and corresponding angles. So three sides and three angles must be equal to the three sides, corresponding three sides and corresponding angles are equal. Now, do we need all six conditions, or lesser number of conditions will ensure the congruence of two triangles? In this section, we shall prove that if three properly chosen conditions out of the six conditions are satisfied, then the other three are automatically satisfied. Let us now discuss those three conditions which ensure.
Right. Students, in this section, we have to prove if three properly chosen conditions are satisfied out of six conditions, then automatically other three will be satisfied. What are the three properly chosen conditions here? So let us now learn about side angle side axiom. What is side angle side axiom? See statement here. If two sides and the included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and the included angle of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. See statements once again. If two sides and the included angle of one triangle, if two sides and the included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and the included angle of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. What is meant by included angle? What is included angle here? Included angle. What is meant by included angle? Included angle means the angle which is in between the given sides. The angle which is in between the given sides is called as included angle. What is included angle means? The included angle means the angle which is in between the given sides is called included angle. For example, in triangle ABC, here is triangle ABC. So this side is AB and this side is BC. For these two sides, AB and BC, what is included angle here for AB and BC? With these two sides, the angle B, for AB and BC, the angle B is the included angle. For the sides AC and BC, what is the included angle here? The angle C is the included angle here. Right? Therefore, angle C is included angle for sides AC and sides BC.
Angle B is the included angle for side AB and side BC. Also, angle A is the included angle for side AB and side AC. So, included angle means, for example, in triangle ABC, for AB and AC, for sides AB and BC, angle B is the included side. For sides AB and AC, angle A is the included side. For sides AC and BC, angle C is the included angle. Congruency axiom. If two sides and the included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and the included angle of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. See one example here. If in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, in triangles ABC and DEF, if AB equal to DE and BC equal to EF and angle B equal to angle E. So here three conditions are given, three equalities are given. What are three equalities here? AB equal to DE and BC equal to EF and angle B is equal to angle E. Angle B equal to angle E. Other three equalities are not given. Now we have to prove these two triangles are congruent or not. See here, two sides and one included angle is given. For these two sides, so AB is given and BC is given. For these two sides, angle B is the included angle because the angle B is in between these two sides. Therefore, angle B is the included angle. So also, AB equal to DE, so AB equal to DE and BC is equal to EF. So in this triangle DEF also, for sides DE and EF, angle E is the included angle because the angle E is in between the given two sides. Therefore, angle E is the included angle. Therefore, two sides and one included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and included angle of the other triangle, then we can say that these two triangles are congruent. That means triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. This means when we write triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF, the six equalities are held good. Three are already given, other three are also equal. Therefore, see here, AB equal to DE, which is already given, and BC equal to EF, this is also given here, BC is equal to EF, and angle B equal to angle E. So, what are other three? That means, by CP, CT, by corresponding parts of congruent triangles, we can write AC equal to DF, also angle A equal to angle D and angle C equal to angle F. This is called as side angle side congruency axiom. From the side angle side axiom, we have to check whether the given triangles are congruent or not. Check them. What is side angle side congruence axiom? If two sides and one included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and included angle of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Right? What is given here? Here triangle MNO and triangle XYZ is given. In these two, MN is equal to, in these two triangles, MN is equal to side MN is equal to side XY. Side MN is equal to side XY. Also, side NO is equal to side YZ. And Further, these two sides, MN and NO, this angle is included angle because this angle in between these two given sides. Therefore, this is an included angle. Therefore, angle N equal to, this is also included angle for this triangle. So, these two are given two sides and this angle is in between the given two sides. Therefore, this is also included angle. Therefore, angle N equal to angle Y. For this situation, SAS congruency rule holds because two sides and the included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and the included angle of the other triangle. Therefore, by SAS congruency rule, we have to write triangle MNO is congruent to triangle XYZ. See the letters order. MN equal to XY, correct? And NO equal to YZ, correct? And angle N equal to angle Y. So, these are in order which satisfies the given statement. Therefore, triangle MNO is congruent to triangle XYZ. So, by CPCD, what will we write here? By CPCD, two sides are already equal. What are the third side here? MN and NO. Automatically, third side MO is equal to side XZ. In the given statement, one angle is given. Angle N equal to angle Y. By SAS congruency rule, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, angle M equal to angle X. Angle M equal to angle X. And angle O equal to angle Z. So, from this, if three properly chosen conditions are satisfied, then automatically other three conditions are also satisfied. So, we can write this. See the second example once. Here is the second example. In this example, in this triangle PQR, is angle Q is included angle for the given two sides? What is the included angle for the given two sides? Included angle for given two sides is angle R, but it is not given. This is another angle, not an included angle. Therefore, here SAS congruency rule not applies. Therefore, we cannot say we have not information. We have not proper information to say about these two triangles are congruent or not. Therefore, we cannot say these two triangles are congruent. Because this angle is not an included angle, we cannot say these two triangles are congruent.
Students, see here, other congruence rule, angle side angle congruence rule. Theorem 7.1. See once here statement. What is the statement given here? If two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and the included side of the other triangle, then the given two triangles are congruent. See once. If two angles and the included side, if two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and the included side of the other triangle, then the given two triangles are congruent. See here, two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and the included side of the other triangle, then we can say the given two triangles are congruent. We have to prove this theorem with the example here. See here, what is given in theorem 7.1 statement? If two angles and one included side of one triangle
are equal to the two angles and the included side of the another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. See here, what is given in this statement? Given that, see here, in triangles ABC and DEF, in triangle ABC and DEF, triangles ABC and DEF, what is given here? Two angles and included side. So, in triangle ABC, angle P and angle C are equal to the corresponding, equal to the angles, angle E and angle F respectively. That means, angle B equal to angle E and angle C equal to angle F. Also, what is given? BC equal to EF. BC equal to EF. This is also given. And BC equal to EF. This is given. Two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and the included side of the other triangle. Then what we require to prove? We require to prove here is triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. We have to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. Right. In these two figures, see once. In triangles ABC and DEF, for sides AB and DE, there are three possibilities. What are the three possibilities between AB and DE? Are either AB equal to DE, or AB is greater than DE, or AB is less than DE. For the sides, here AB and DE, in triangles ABC and DEF, there are three possibilities are there. What are the three possibilities here? There are three possibilities between the sides, between the sides AB and DE. What are the three possibilities here? If AB equal to DE or AB is greater than DE or AB is less than DE, there are only three possibilities are there. So we have to check first possibility, case 1. If AB equal to DE, if AB equal to DE, if AB is equal to DE, then in triangles ABC and DEF, in triangles ABC and DEF, we have already angle B equal to angle E and BC equal to EF. These two are already given statements. Angle B equal to angle E and BC equal to EF. Angle B equal to angle E and angle BC equal to EF. Also in the case here, AB equal to DE. For AB and BC, angle B is the included angle. For AB and BC, angle B is the included angle. Also, for DE and EF, angle E is the included angle. Therefore, if two sides or included angle of a triangle are equal to the corresponding two sides and included angle of other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. By SAS congruence rule, we have triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. So when it is happened, if AB equal to DE, there are two more possibilities are there. What are the two more possibilities? AB is greater than DE or AB is less than DE. If AB is equal to DE, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF, which is already proved. If AB is greater than DE, is triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF? See once. If AB is greater than DE, if AB is greater than DE, what will happen? There exists a point P such that there exists a point P on the line segment AB, on the side AB, such that PB is equal to DE. If AB is greater than DE, there exists a point P such that PB equal to DE. If AB is greater than DE, then they register a point P such that PB equal to DE. So here is P, let in triangle PBC PB equal to DE. In triangles PBC and DEF, we have PB equal to DE. This is our assumption. And BC equal to EF, this is given. And angle D equal to angle E, this is also given. These two are given. And this is our assumption, PB equal to DE from our assumption. Therefore, in these two triangles, triangle PBC and triangle DEF, two sides and one include angle of one triangle are equal to two sides one include angle of the other triangle. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, triangle PBC is congruent to triangle DEF. That means by CPCT, we have this angle PCP or angle PCB equal to angle PCB is equal to angle DFE. But in the given statement, we have angle F is equal to angle C. Angle C equal to angle F. When it is possible, that means angle PCB equal to angle ACB. Angle PCB equal to angle ACB. When it is possible, if P coincides with A only, this is possible. Therefore, AB equal to DE. If AB equal to DE, we have already proved in case 1, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. Now, let us check case 3. If AB equal to DE, then triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. AB is greater than DE is not possible. Therefore, AB equal to DE. Now check case 3. What is the third possibility here? If AB is less than DE. So in case 3, since AB is less than DE, there must be a point on DE such that ME is equal to AB. Therefore, there exists a point M such that a point M on DE such that ME is equal to AB. Right. See here, ME equal to AB. Then what will happen?
ME equal to AB, ME equal to AB, our assumption, and BC equal to EF, that is given, and angle B equal to angle E. These two are given statements. This is our assumption. See here, AB, BC, for AB and BC, this is included angle. Also, ME and EF, this is included angle. By SAS congruence rule, we have triangle ABC is congruent to triangle MEF. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle MEF. This means the corresponding parts of these two triangles are also equal. That means angle ACB equal to angle ACB equal to angle MFE. Angle MFE. Already in the given statement, angle ACB equal to angle DFE. Angle ACB equal to angle DFE. That means angle MFE equal to angle DFE. When angle MFE is equal to angle DFE, when angle M coincides with the angle D only, MFE equal to DFE. Therefore, that means AB equal to D. That means AB equal to D. Therefore, if AB equal to D, then we already proved triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. Therefore, if two angles, one included side is given, then the given two triangles are congruent.